Students, welcome to the series of organic chemistry. Today we are going to learn about aromatic hydrocarbons. Aromatic compounds are also known as arenes because of their odor or the smell. These compounds are benzenoids. For example, benzene, toluene, naphthalene, biphenyl. Other compounds which are having benzene-like properties but do not have benzene, they are known as non-benzenoids. Nomenclature. For example, if I take toluene, so let us number from here 1, 2, 5, 6, right? So the usual nomenclature follows like this. This is 1-methyl benzene, or you can write it as methyl benzene. This methyl benzene is also known as toluene. The common name of this methyl benzene is toluene. If I substitute, or if I put some functional group or some group here, let us write methyl here, then it will become ortho methyl. This ortho position is either of these two sides. 2 and 6 positions are ortho positions. So fourth position is known as para position. This, whereas 3 and 5 position meta positions. This is OMP, ortho, meta, para. This is with respect to this substituent. Without substituent, there is no question of ortho, meta, para. For example, if I write methyl here, it is going to be toluene. So don't say that meta methyl benzene. No, it is toluene only. With respect to this methyl group, now it becomes ortho, meta, para. So this is 1,3 dimethyl benzene. This is 1,4 dimethyl benzene. So 1,3, this position is meta. Para position, it is 1,4 dimethyl benzene. Structure of benzene, molecular formula of benzene is C6H6. This formula doesn't fit either of these alkene or alkynes. So what is the structure? And these 6 carbons are attached to 6 hydrogen atoms. So this structure was first postulated by Kekulé. What is the Kekulé structure? He had a dream of catching snake its tail. That means 6 carbons. This is, if I write, it is head and this is tail, right? So this carbon is catching its tail. So based on that dream, he proposed a cyclic structure. He said that all 6 carbons are attached to 6 hydrogen atoms. Hydrogens. So if I write like this, it is different. This, suppose if I number here 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So you may say that the bond between 1 and 2 is single bond, whereas the bond between 2 and 3 is double bond. So it should, or it must possess single bond character reactions and double bond character reactions. However, it is not going to be the same. Then how to justify its structure? Means, for example, if I take dibromobenzene, it is ortho bromo bromobenzene, or 1,2 dibromobenzene. It should have single bond dibromo compound and double bond dibromo compound, isn't it? However, it is not possible to write these two compounds. Then he suggested, Kekulé, by suggesting the concept of oscillating nature of double bonds. Double bonds always oscillates, means this double bond comes here, this double bond comes here, and this double bond goes here, to give these two structures where this bromine and this bromine always in oscillation. That means this is resonance in structure. That further, after valence bond theory concept, this structure is confirmed by resonance. This is resonance. If the Kekulé structures are these, A and B are Kekulé structures proposed by Kekulé, it is further modified, or it is confirmed based on valence bond theory, that this double bonds undergoes always resonance. Means if I write to this structure, this is single bond, means then it becomes single bond character, or sp2 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 sp2, all are sp2, right? So in this structure, what we'll do is, how many sigma bonds are there? Yes students, this question was asked in 2020 NEET exam. So count the sigma bonds in benzene. How to count? So double bond also consists of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 2, 3, 4, 5 C's, sigma bonds. So please count the sigma bonds which are in the hexagonal plane. Here it is explained, it is in hexagonal plane. Write down the hexagon of benzene. So all are sigma bonds. So these are hydrogen sigma bonds. 6 hydrogens are attached to benzene hexagon with 6 sigma bonds. These are hydrogens, while these 6 carbons are attached with each other with CC 6 sigma bonds and CH are 6 sigma bonds. Then the remaining p orbital undergoes side on overlapping either of 1 2 3 4 5 6 or 2 3 4 5 6 1 or 1 6. How this double bond always under resonance, so always write like this. Benzene you can write either structure A, yes you can write it is accepted. Structure B, it is accepted. And you can write, usually it is not written like this. So this structure you can write it as G. That means this pi electrons, so these pi electrons, pi bond electrons which undergoes double bond, yes, side on overlapping of pz orbital. Pz orbital gives resonance of pi bond. This pi bond always in resonance to give benzene structure, which can be written as circle, which can be written as circle inside the benzene ring like this. So if I take donut, so in South India it is known as Mysore Bajji. So I take Mysore Bajji and put one over the other, it looks like this one. So where the electron density is in between these two circles, or I can write like this, donuts, electron clouds will be in between these. Dear students, it is very very important to understand the concept of resonance, which was proposed by Kekulé, where total how many sigma bonds are there in benzene? Yes, so 6 sigma bonds and 6 CH sigma bonds, total 12 sigma bonds are there. Yes students, so the 6 pi electrons are thus delocalized and can be freely 6 carbon nuclei. So these pi electrons goes on moving between 6 carbons. So is it electron rich or poor? This benzene ring is electron rich. So since it is electron rich, it is stable compound. So to continue this electron rich character or this resonance structure, there are some principles it must undergo, then only the compound can be said to have resonance structure. Then what is the bond length in benzene? We know that CC single bond length is 154 picometers, whereas CC double bond is 133 picometers. However, if you take benzene, it is either single bond or double bond. In between single bond and double bond, that is 139 picometers. Dear students, please remember this value, 139 picometer. So it is neither undergoes single bond reactions nor double bond reactions. It is undergoes aromatic substitution reactions. That is why the benzene will not undergo usual addition reactions without losing its aromatic character. Is not possible addition reactions, it will not undergo. Nucleophilic substitution reactions will not undergo. However, it undergoes electrophilic substitution reactions. So this is the peculiar character of benzene. This is how benzene is said to have resonance structure. Then what is important thing? Aromaticity. With respect to annual exams, all competitive exams, aromatic concept is very very important. Just remember or by heart this. So planarity, so what is the hybridization of carbons in benzene? All 6 carbons are sp2 hybridized carbons. Sp2 hybridized carbons are planar, so it is planar. All sp2 compounds are planar. Sp compounds linear, sp3 tetrahedral. So the first criteria to be aromatic, it must be planar compound. Complete delocalization of the pi electrons in the ring. This complete delocalization takes place when it is alternative double bonds only, delocalization takes place. And one more important key point is presence of 4n plus 2 pi electrons. For example, if n equal to 0, 4n 0 plus 2. So it is not given in your book, so please pay the attention. If 0, 4 into 0 is 0 plus 2. 2 pi electrons containing compound also aromatic. It is very very important students to hear benzene. How many pi electrons are there? If n equal to 1, if 4n 1 plus 2, 4 into 1 is 4 plus 2 is 6. Then if 2, let us write 4 into 2 plus 2, it is going to be 4 2 ja 8 plus 2 10. If n equal to 3, it is going to be 4 3 ja 12 plus 2, it is 14. So the compounds, just remember like this, the compounds having 2 pi electrons, 6 pi electrons, 10 pi electrons or 14 pi electrons, write n number of pi electrons. 4 into 4 anilines, you will find this kind of structures. 4 into 4, 16 plus 2, it is 18 pi electrons. 2, 6, 10, 14, 18 pi electrons. It follows 4n plus pi electrons. However, it must follow number one structure planarity, and the double bonds must be under resonance. It doesn't matter whether it have 6 pi electrons, but there is no alternate double bonds, then it is not going to follow this rule. Let us take one example, benzene. Yes, we are studying benzene is aromatic. So whether it is following the criteria of planarity, yes, all these 6 carbons are sp2 hybridized, so it is planar. Then what is the delocalization? Yes, 6 carbons are under delocalization. These pi electrons are delocalization. Then another point under this is 4n plus 2 pi electrons. How many pi electrons are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 pi electrons. So this 4n plus 2 pi electrons formula was proposed by Huckel. So this rule is also known as Huckel's rule. So benzene is following Huckel's rule and aromatic rules. So it is aromatic compound. Then what about this cyclopentadienyl anion? Anion minus, it will have 2 electrons. So this 1, 2 and here 3 and 4, 5, 6 is having 5 electrons. And this double bond is resonance with, so I can write like this. Yes, so I can delocalize this double bond to here or here and then here, so I can write here. Isn't same? Yes, these two structures are same, so delocalization is possible and it is having 6 pi electrons, so all the criteria is matched. Then what about this cyclopentadienyl cation? First criteria is planarity. So what is the hybridization here? Yes, sp2. So all are sp2 hybridized, so it is planar cycloheptadienyl cation. Yes, is following. What about presence of 4n plus pi electrons? Yes, 6 pi electrons. So 6 pi electrons planarity. 2 points are matching. Yes students, it is aromatic. Yes, delocalization is possible like this. This is cyclopropene carbocation. It is also an aromatic compound. How? Let us see. 1 and 2. 2 pi electron containing compound. Yes. So what is the hybridization of these 3 carbons? sp2, sp2 and sp2. Isn't it? So these 3 carbons are sp2 hybridized. So it is planar in structure and resonance. Yes, I can write resonance here. So this positive charge, then this comes here, this positive charge, right? So p ions usually you come across are, so these p compounds are very very important, you have to remember. So though these are not looks like benzene and it is alternate, so 3 carbon chain, 7 carbon chain, 5 carbon chain, though these compounds do not have double bonds continuously, so this carbocation and this carbocation, because of this resonance and sp2 hybridized and 2 pi electrons, this is 6 pi electrons and this is 6 pi electrons. So these 3 compounds are aromatic. Then you can take anthracene. anthracene, how many pi bonds are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 pi electrons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14. 14 pi electrons. Is it aromatic? Yes. Phenanthrene is aromatic. Anthracene is aromatic. So these compounds, all the compounds which are having 4n plus 2 pi electrons. 4n plus pi 2 means n means a integer. You can take 0, 1, 2, any n number. So the value what you are going to get, if it matches this pi electrons, then the compound is said to be aromatic compound. Then preparation of benzene. Benzene is commercially isolated from coal tar. So laboratory is very rare. However, you can prepare from ethane, that is acetylene. Upon passing acetylene gas on red hot copper tube or iron tube above 600 degrees centigrade, you are going to get benzene. Decarboxylation of aromatic acids. Yes, this is decarboxylation equation, where during the reaction also, if I heat benzoic acid with soda lime, that is sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide, it is going to lose sodium carbonate, as this carbon decarboxylation is going to take place to give benzene. If there is some substituent here, for example nitro is here, and if I heat this para nitro benzoic acid with soda lime, it is going to give nitrobenzene. So another method is, so phenols upon reacting with zinc, it is going to lose hydroxide, it is going to give benzene. Next properties is aromatic compound. Yes, it gives a aroma, characteristic aroma. This gives benzene smell. It is specific smell it will have. And when you heat it or when you burn it, it gives fruity flame. And we have seen naphthalene balls. Yes, naphthalene is the compound which is aromatic compound, so which is usually used in toilets. One more thing, since it is organic compound, these compounds are not going to miscible with water. So benzene, if I mix water, it is not going to mix or miscible, immiscible with water. So it forms layer. For example, if I take separating funnel, right, separating funnel, and add water and benzene, so it forms layers. Here I will have benzene is top and below is water. So aromatic compounds will be above the water because the density of aromatic compounds is less than water. See, these are immiscible. Aromatic compounds can be used for extracting organic compounds from water. Yes, this is how. Physical properties, then chemical properties. Dear students, chemical properties of benzene are very, very important. Yes, so it will not undergo aromatic addition reactions. Nucleophilic addition reactions will not undergo, right? Whereas substitution reactions, it is not neither SN1, SN2, no. Whereas it undergoes aromatic electrophilic substitution. It is very, very specific reactions. Aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. These substitution reactions can be written like this. Aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction. Under this aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction, we will learn nitration, sulfonation, and Friedel-Crafts alkylation and acylation reactions, then halogenations. Under nitration, nitrogen is going to be substituted on benzene. Substituted. What is substituted here? If I take benzene, this is benzene, right? So the hydrogen is substituted with nitro group, not addition, or neither it is nucleophilic substitution, because it undergoes electrophilic substitution. Electrophilic substitution must follow a key mechanism. What are the key steps involved in aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction? The first step is generation of electrophile. For example, the reacting species, this electrophilic substitution or nucleophilic substitution name depends on the incoming reactant. For example, if I write this is benzene, yes, so the incoming electrophile, if it is electrophile, then it is known as electrophilic substitution reaction. This electrophile, the benzene or aromatic compounds, most of the reactions are aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. It follows three steps. The first step is generation of electrophile and formation of carbocation intermediate And the third step is removal of proton from the carbocation intermediate. Yes, so to get back its aromatic nature. So these are the three steps always it follows. Formation of electrophile. This is electrophile. R chlorine chloronium ion is electrophile. For example, if I take chlorine, in presence of aluminum chloride, it forms chloronium ion. This is electrophile. If I take methyl chloride, in presence of aluminum chloride, it gives methyl carbocation, which is electrophile. This is electrophile. And this is acylium, acyl carbocation, acylium. So this acylium carbocation can be formed from acetyl chloride. In presence of aluminum chloride, it takes up chlorine to give acyl carbocation. In the case of nitration, formation of nitronium ion takes place like this. So sulfuric acid is going to act as acid and HNO3 is going to act as base. Formation of nitronium ion takes place in presence of sulfuric acid and nitric acid. So this sulfuric acid can be taken as concentrated sulfuric acid and this is concentrated nitric acid HNO3. So this HNO3 takes up proton from sulfuric acid and loses water to give nitronium ion. It is very very important, students. Formation of nitronium ion and formation of acylium ion, and these electrophiles are actual reacting species. That is why electrophilic substitution reaction. Based on this, it is named as electrophilic substitution reaction. Formation of carbocation or arenium ion. So based on Kekulé structure, if you write the resonance structures, so this electrophile, it is electron loving species, isn't it? Electrophile is electron poor compound or species which loves electrons. Since this double bond is electron rich, it gives electrons to electrophile to form this sigma complex. This carbocation intermediate is also known as sigma complex. At this stage, what is the hybridization of this carbon? It is sp3 and it is sp2, right? So this sigma complex are resonance stabilized. So this positive charge can be resonantly stabilized by this double bond to give carbocation at this place or at this place, or this can be written as this cyclic sigma complex. This is why you can write, so here it is not complete cycle, so it is sigma complex, it is not complete cycle. This is single bond character, whereas these pi carbons or these carbons are in the form of resonance structure. So this stage is known as sigma complex. Now this sigma complex easily loses this proton to get back its aromatic nature. So this proton can be taken up by aluminum chloride, where this chlorine takes up this proton to out as HCl and aluminum chlorine will be regenerated. This Lewis acid is easily accepts chlorine in the above reaction, right? In nitration reaction, this proton is going to be taken up by sulfate ion. Sulfate ion, it is going to be out as sulfuric acid. So this is how aromatic electrophilic substitution reaction takes place. So the main key steps in this reaction steps are formation of electrophile, then sigma complex, followed by removal of hydrogen. Removal of hydrogen is nothing but to get back its aromatic character. It is going to out as hydrogen with its Lewis acid. So to give aromatic compound, now the compound is, we got electrophilic substituted benzene. So what are the common reactions we come across? Nitration. So what is going to happen here? Nitrogen is substituted here. So this hydrogen is substituted with nitrogen. And this place, so this hydrogen is substituted with chlorine. What is the electrophile here? Cl chloronium ion. Cl plus chloronium ion. So here, fuming sulfuric acid sulfonation. So here it is going to be SO3. H sulfonium ion. And Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction, it is very very important, students. So here we are going to get ethyl carbocation or ethyl carbocation, ethyl benzene, toluene, like this we are going to get. So here the question frames here, this question is asked many times. So if I take 1-chloropropane aluminum chloride here, what you are going to get? Formation of carbocation. what you say, form carbocation here, right? So this chlorine by aluminium to give carbocation. This carbocation or electrophile should be substituted on this benzene to give n-propyl benzene, but it is not going to be obtained. But why? So it has been asked in n number of times. Why? It is very simple, students. During the mechanism, as soon as it forms carbocation, this is primary carbocation. Hydrogen takes up this carbocation to give secondary carbocation, which is more stable. Secondary carbocation, this is CH3CH, this is CH3. We know that what is the stability of carbocations? Tertiary is more stable, then secondary, then primary. Yes, so to get back its more stability of this carbocation, secondary carbocation is going to be formed by rearrangement of this primary carbocation. It is very, very important concept. Now, this carbocation or this electrophile is going to react with benzene to give isopropyl benzene. Because of stability of carbocations or electrophile, it undergoes rearrangement of this proton to give isopropyl carbocation. Secondary carbocation is more stable to give isopropyl benzene. Isopropyl benzene is also known as cumene. When it comes to Friedel-Crafts acylation reaction, what is the reacting species? Acylium carbocation. It can be generated from acetic anhydride. This acetic anhydride minus the acid, it is going to give this acylium carbocation. This acylium carbocation is going to react with benzene or undergoes electrophilic substitution reactions. So what are the electrophilic substitution reactions? Usually it undergoes nitration, sulfonation, chlorination to Friedel-Crafts alkylation, Friedel-Crafts acylation reactions. So what are the important steps or mechanism of this electrophilic substitution? Follows three steps: for generation of electrophile, formation of sigma complex, and removal of proton from carbocation intermediate. So what about other reactions? If I use excess of acetic anhydride, excess of this reagent, acetyl chloride or nitric acid or whatever the reagent, what is going to happen? Excess substitution or more substitution is going to take place. For example, chlorination, if I use excess chlorine, it is going to form hexachlorobenzene. It is not benzene hexachloride, HCB. It is substitution compound, HCB. It is not BHC, HCB. It undergoes substitution reaction, because there is other reaction where it undergoes addition reaction. So you may be asked to differentiate between the reagents or the reaction products of addition and substitution reactions. It is substitution product where it is going to give hexachlorobenzene, C6Cl6 chlorobenzene. It is aromatic electrophilic substitution product. So usually aromatic compounds undergoes electrophilic substitution reactions. Next, however, there are few reactions where addition reactions also observed. For example, addition of hydrogen takes place with raninical or palladium or platinum, requires heating, then it requires pressure of hydrogen, means lot of hydrogen. Don't think that it is only three hydrogens are required to undergo addition reactions, but lot of hydrogen, it can be pumped or it be under high pressure only it undergoes this addition reaction. The question can be asked in this way. It was asked in NEET. Nitrobenzene, if I do hydrogenation, they have given like this: hydrogen and one atmosphere at RT. So what is the product? It is going to reduce only nitrogen. It is not going to reduce, or this addition of hydrogen on benzene is not going to take place under at room temperature. So it is going to give here aniline. You are going to learn these reactions in second year or class. Yes, students. So it is going to give only aniline, but there is no question of undergoing reduction or addition of hydrogens to benzene. Chlorination, benzene upon addition reaction, it is going to give benzene hexachloride. This benzene hexachloride is also known as gamaxane. It is used as insecticide to repel the ants. You can use it as gamaxane powder. So this is BHC, can be prepared upon chlorination under UV, so please pay the attention, UV and 500K, that means it is under heating reactions. 500K, it is nothing but around 230 degree centigrade, high temperature, chlorine and UV light. So previous case it was under dark reactions. Yes, so reaction takes place at anhydride using catalyst of aluminum chloride, chlorine, dark and cold conditions. It gives hexachlorobenzene, whereas addition reaction takes place under high temperature. Addition reaction takes place because already this benzene ring is rich of electrons. It is not going to add with these nucleophiles. Here it is going to add to nucleophiles. It is not going to add to other addition products, right? So it is not going to undergo electrophilic addition reaction, right? Electrophile and nucleophile, during addition reaction both electrophile and nucleophile are going to add, for example chlorine, chlorine. So since it is under UV light, it is going to follow free radical mechanism, right? Here also hydrogen and hydrogen, radical mechanism, radical addition is going to take place. Anyhow, so these are common, only two addition reactions, don't worry. So the major important reactions are electrophilic substitution reaction. Next comes combustion. Aromatic compounds or alkanes or alkenes or alkynes follows a common principle or equation where you are asked to write even this equation also. So please remember students, CXY plus X plus Y4 oxygen gives carbon dioxide. Whatever may be the number of carbons, it is going to give carbon dioxide and Y by 2 of water. What is the molecular formula of benzene? For example, see, let us write how many oxygens are required, C6H6, using X, it is 6 plus 6 by 4, what is the oxygen? So what is this value it is going to be? How to do this? Yes, you can calculate it like this. 4 into 6 is 24 plus now whole by 4. Now it is whole by 4 oxygen. That means 30 by 4 is nothing but 15 by 2. 15 by 2 oxygen is going to give NCO2, means what is the formula? Y by 2 plus what is Y here? C by 2 is H2. This is the general combustion formula to give water molecules. Forms CO2 plus 3H2. This is how you can calculate. C6HY plus X plus Y by 4O2 gives rise to XCO2. The XCO2, or you can take it as the number of carbons, whatever may be the number, you are going to get that number of carbon dioxide plus Y by 2 of water, right? So another important thing of these aromatic compounds is directing groups. Directing groups means the incoming electrophile takes up the position ortho or para. The directing group, for example phenol, due to mesomeric effect of these lone pair electrons, these lone pair electrons are going to be activate benzene ring activating groups or ortho and para directing groups. The incoming group is not going to any position, it is directed by the substituent already present on benzene. For example, if I take phenol, it is going to direct ortho and para. Why it is like this? The lone pair electrons on oxygen is going to be back donated to this benzene ring to give these resonance structures. Here it is carbanion, it is going to be ortho position, carbanion, here it is para position, and here it is ortho position. In this structure, electron rich carbon is going to be formed ortho, para and ortho. So electrophilic substitution takes place on phenol is ortho and para. So phenol OH group is ortho and para directing groups. These phenol group or OH compounds, like compounds, are known to be activating group, right? Or this is known as directing group. This OH group activates the benzene ring for the attack by electrophile, isn't it? So other electrophilic activating groups, for example amine, aniline, or even NHR and methoxy, methyl and ethyl, alkyl substituted compound is going to be ortho and para, because this stanylite group is going to be ortho para. You may have doubt, this OH group, though it is minus I affecting group, don't confuse with inductive effect and mesomeric effect. It is simple. It follows isomeric effect. Because of this R, this donation of lone pair electrons to this single bond, it is going to form this double bond like compound from ortho para. Though it is minus I, it is less effect at this position. So OH and chlorine also follows same like phenol. It is going to ortho and para. Halogens are ortho para directing groups, and this amine, diethyl and methyl, also halogens, phenols and alkyl groups also are ortho and para. Why? Because it is going to form anion at ortho and para position. Why these groups are ortho para directing groups? When it comes to meta directing groups, so meta directing groups are minus I affecting groups or minus inductive affecting groups, which pulls the electron density from benzene to towards oxygen. Is deactivating, it is taking, so it is deactivating groups. It activates this ring, or this benzene ring is electron excess group, but if it donates trans to nitrogen, it is going to lose aromatic nature. So that is why it is deactivating groups. So it is deactivating aromatic character. So these deactivating groups are going to form carbocations on benzene. As we learned that aromatic compounds usually undergoes electrophilic substitution reactions. Since forming carbocation at ortho and para position, yes, this is ortho carbocation and para carbocation and ortho carbocation. Is it going to undergo nucleophilic addition reactions of benzene? So it should undergo nucleophilic addition. If it undergoes nucleophilic addition, it is not going to be aromatic compound. Yes, it is not going to be aromatic compound. Then what is the question? If I add nucleophile here, is it going to be aromatic this compound? No. So it is not going to undergo nucleophilic substitution reaction. However, these ortho and para are carbocations. Their meta position is going to undergo nucleophilic substitution reactions. So meta directing groups are the groups which are minus I affecting groups. For example, nitro, cyanide, aldehyde, ketone, acid, ester, sulfonic acid. For example, if I do electrophs acylation to phenone, right? If I use excess of acetyl chloride and do the reaction, what is the compound I am going to get? Is it ortho diacetyl or para diacetyl or meta? Yes, it is expected to be meta directing group. So I should get meta acetyl estophenone. Yes, so if it is alkylation reaction, polyalkylation usually takes place. If it is alkylation reaction, is toluene is formed under Fischer-Tropsch alkylation. So the next methyl group, where should I expect? Either ortho or para, because this methyl group is ortho para directing group. So I can get ortho methyl toluene or here xylene. Usual name is xylene or ortho para xylenes I am going to get, but not metaxylene. So this is how. So these compounds, common directing groups are nitro, cyanide, aldehyde. So you may be confused this aldehyde and acyl groups. So that is why I have given this acyl group. Why? It is very simple. Double bond, I write double bond here. It is benzene ring. It is going to take up, and this is going to be meta directing group, right? So when it comes to methyl group, this is going to form like this. Double bond is going to be activating nature of this methyl group is going to be ortho and para directing groups, right? So this is how deactivating groups. So a thorough with activating the deactivating groups, then only you can answer some questions. For example, if I want to make ortho chloro nitro benzene from benzene, so what is the reaction or how do you follow from benzene? What to do? I take nitrobenzene and do the chlorination. This nitro is meta directing group, so the chlorine will be attached onto this meta position. Yes, so I cannot follow nitrobenzene route. I must follow chlorobenzene followed by nitration. That means this is sequence. If you know the reactions, then only. For example, do HNO3 nitration and write NO2 plus nitrobenzene and HNO3, I will get chlorobenzene upon chlorine, aluminum chloride. What is the product? Guess, AlCl3. What is the product here? You have to answer. Same benzene, if I do first chlorine and aluminum chloride halogenation going to get chlorobenzene. So benzene, this chlorobenzene upon nitration HNO3 HTSO4 concentrated HTSO4, it is nothing but it is going to give nitronium ion HNO3. This is 2 moles, usually sulfuric acid can be taken as 2 moles and HNO3 is 1 mole. At least one mixture it is taken, and now nitration takes place at ortho position. Ortho position, because this chlorine is ortho para directing group, so I am going to get this chlorine is intact and nitro is going to be here. So ortho nitro chlorobenzene is going to be formed, whereas this case it is going to benzene is here. Now nitro is intact here, isn't it? This case nitro is meta directing group, it is going to form metachloronitrobenzene. So you are going to be asked like this: if I want to prepare orthochloronitrobenzene, what is the route? So it is very important to know the activating and deactivating groups of these nitrobenzene and chlorobenzene. Chlorine is ortho para, whereas nitro is meta directing group. So if I substitute at this position all these groups, anhydride, aldehyde, this acyl group or acid group or other group or sulfonic acid group, these are all going to be meta directing group, whereas phenol, alkyl or halogens are going to be ortho para directing group. The important thing is, so this diethyl tonylide is going to be ortho para directing group. So directing and deactivating groups are very important in aromatic substitution reactions. Then carcinogenicity and toxicity, it is theory based. It is going to be polynuclear hydrocarbons containing more than 2 benzene rings. So that is why benzene is highly toxic compound. So the use of benzene in organic chemistry labs, it is restricted during these days because of its carcinogenicity. Carcinogenicity is causing cancer. So nowadays benzene is not used as common solvent as before because of its carcinogenicity. So most of the benzene containing compounds are found to damage DNA and cause the compounds are found to have carcinogenic character or property. For example, 1,2-benz, this is anthracene, 1,2-benz anthracene, these are all carcinogenic hydrocarbons. 3-methylcholanthrene, so 3-methyl is 3-methylcholanthrene, it is named like that, right? So choanthine, and this is 1,2-benzpyrene, and 1,2,5,6-dibenzanthracene. 1,2,5,6. 1,2,3,4,5. 1,2,5,6-dibenzanthracene. This is mono benzanthracene, dibenzanthracene. It is 9,10-dimethyl-1,2-benzanthracene. This is 1,2-benzanthracene, 9,10. 1,2,3,4,5. This is numbering 6, 7, 8. 10-dimethyl-9,10-dimethyl-1,2-benzanthracene. These are all carcinogenic compounds. Dear students, under hydrocarbons, we have learned that hydrocarbons are the compounds of carbon and hydrogen only. There is no other functional groups or oxygens. So, for example, hydrocarbons are mainly obtained from coal tar and petroleum. So, most of the hydrocarbons are petrochemicals, are prominent starting materials used for the manufacture of large number of important products, can be prepared PG gas, natural gas, CNG, and energy for domestic fuels and the automatic industry. Hydrocarbons are classified as open chain saturated alkanes. Saturated means alkanes, unsaturated is alkynes and alkenes, and cyclic, alicyclic compounds and aromatic compounds according to their structure. Aromatic compounds are saturated or unsaturated compounds? Yes, aromatic compounds are unsaturated compounds. The important reactions of alkanes are free radical substitution. Yes, halogenation we have seen, combustion, oxidation and aromatization. And alkenes and alkynes undergoes addition reactions. It is very important, students. Alkenes and alkynes, unsaturated compounds, undergoes addition reactions, which are mainly electrophilic addition reactions. Yes, so whereas alkanes undergoes mainly substitution reaction most of the times, and aromatic hydrocarbons, despite having unsaturation, just know what I said, unsaturated compounds like alkenes, alkynes undergoes electrophilic addition reactions. However, benzene, despite of having unsaturation, undergo mainly electrophilic substitution, which is also known as aromatic electrophilic substitution reactions. These undergo addition reactions only under special conditions, and alkanes show conformational isomerism due to free rotation along CC bonds. I have explained this alkanes chapter in detail on whiteboard, and you can that chapter. I am going to give the links below of this video. Out of staggered and eclipsed conformations of ethane, staggered conformation is more stable as hydrogen atoms are farthest apart. Yes, this is also I explained. Staggered and eclipsed forms. Alkenes exhibit geometrical cis-trans isomerism and nomenclature I explained under alkenes due to restricted rotation around the CC double bond. Yes, just now what we have learned? Benzene and benzenite compounds show aromatic character, that is aromaticity. The property of being aromatic is possessed by compounds having specific conic structure characterized by Hockel's rule, that is 4N plus 2 pi electron rule. The nature of groups or substituents attached to benzene ring is responsible for activation or deactivation of benzene ring towards other electrophilic substitution, and also orientation of the incoming group. Yes, students? So based on the already present group, the incoming electrophile takes the orientation or ortho or para position. Some of the polynuclear hydrocarbons having fused benzene ring systems have carcinogenic property. Dear students, we have learnt all these things under hydrocarbon. This is how it ends, students. Next, we are going to solve exercises from this textbook.